this structure, anterior mid-cingulate cortex, has inputs and outputs from a bunch of places, but you'll probably not be surprised to learn that it's strongly activated when we move our body, mm-hmm. when we don't want to move our body. I feel like it's like the David Goggins structure, right?
It really is.
And it also has strong connections to the dopamine reward pathway. Mm-hmm. And everyone goes, yay, dopamine reward. Everyone loves dopamine. Mm-hmm. I'm partially responsible for people knowing a bit more about dopamine. Mm-hmm. But dopamine's badly understood. Everyone thinks dopamine hits. It's about reward. It's about motivation and drive. And there are pain inputs to the dopamine centers of the brain. No one talks about that. Everyone's like, oh, you want the chocolate, you know, chocolate, sex, cocaine. All that. Yeah, that's all true.
Right.
You release dopamine. Pain releases dopamine. The anterior mid-cingulate cortex can trigger the release of dopamine in response to this thing that we're calling friction. And that's a learned thing. That's something that no animal or human being comes into the world learning. We all are averse to pain mm-hmm. and like pleasure, like sugar, fat, don't like hot surfaces.
Right.
But this is a structure that learns. Mm-hmm. It has neuroplasticity, the ability to change throughout the entire lifespan. And here's the part that I think, again, this is just neuro nerd speak for what you already know and have done and exemplify, is that people say, oh, it has plasticity, you can change it. But guess what? It has plasticity in both directions. It can grow, but just as easily as it can grow, it's like silly putty, it can shrink.
Right.
So it requires constant upkeep.
Right.
And that answer isn't one that people are going to like.
Nope.
They're like, give me the energy drink, give me the supplement, give me the sauna protocol that's going to make my anterior mid-cingulate cortex. Yes. Someone out there right now is going, wait, if I took transcranial magnetic stimulation and I stimulate, yeah, you'd probably, actually they've done that. They've stuck a little wire during neurosurgery into this structure. This is actually discovered by a colleague of mine, Joe Parvizi. Stimulate, and the patients go, I feel like there's a storm coming. And they go, oh, is it scary? And they go, no, I want to go through it. Mm-hmm. They come off the stimulation and people are like, this is the seat of what we're talking about.
Right, exactly.
And it learns. So the fact that you kept this brain structure, I'm convinced if we imaged your brain, it'd be large and it would be larger in 2 years, a year. But this is the no days off rationale because it can grow and it can shrink.